DC, it's Ron. Thanks for joining me. Hey, I've got some cool vinyl lined up today. I've got some albums. I've got a little stack of 45s, and we're going to take a look at a 1967 Crawdaddy magazine that came out 50 years ago this month. So that has got some cool stuff in it, so you definitely want to see that. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to break this down to two videos. Part one will be the albums, and then part two will be the 45s and the magazine. Now, you might have seen my previous video, Canadian Vinyl, and I thought it was pretty good. And I got a couple of comments, I watched it back, did some fact checking, and you know what? That video was full of misinformation. See, what I did was I pulled all that stuff out of my collection, turned my camera on, and just started talking. So I was going by memory on those facts, and those facts were wrong. So I really apologize. You gotta remember I'm getting on in years, and so that's why I've got my certified old fart t-shirt on. Seen that, done that, can't remember any of it. Well, that's what that video's about. And you know what? If you watch it with an open mind thinking, hey, this guy's good, man, he knows his facts, it's gonna be a great video, right? Okay, that's enough. That's enough BS. Well, let's get going with the showing. I got the first US Damned album, and it's called the Black Album. Came out in 1980, and it's on the IRS label, which stands for International Record Syndicate. This is the original inner sleeve that it came with, and it says IRS at the bottom here. I got a first pressing on the white and rainbow border label. This is a good album. All Music rates it 3.5 stars. And it's considered to be their best album. And yeah, there's various styles on it. I even heard some real early goth. So, very cool album. Definitely check this album out if not heard it. In fact, the Damned were here not too long ago here in Tempe, Arizona. Probably less than a month or two ago they were here. So I think they're on their 40th anniversary tour or something like that. So, very cool, check them out. And I recently heard their very first 45, New Rose, which was the first punk single ever issued in the UK. So I'm going to put a link to that video in my comments, so check it out. Okay, then I got a compilation of John's Children, UK mod from the 60s. And it's called Jagged Time Lapse, Rare and Unreleased. And look at that great picture of the band on the front. Gatefold cover, 180 gram vinyl. Come out in 1998. I got this used. It's on Get Back Italian Import. Very cool. Let me get these track listings because it has descriptions by Andy Ellison and Chris Townsend, who are in the band. This is just so good. I think I might like these guys more than The Creation. I definitely like Desdemona. I think Desdemona is my favorite song by this band, and I like it better than my favorite song for The Creation, which is Making Time. So no insert, nothing like that, but it's got the cool gatefold, so very cool. Then I got 50th anniversary of Frank Zappa, Mothers of Invention, Absolutely Free. And here's the hype sticker. So this says 50th anniversary, 180 gram vinyl, all analog mastering. From the original 1967 tape. Okay, it doesn't say original 1967 master tape, it just says tape. So, I don't know what's up with the master, but it also says with the laser etched bonus disc, 20 minutes from the vault material, and includes the complete libretto. So, let me show the vinyl. Black vinyl. Side four is blank with the laser etching. And it's Frank. This sounded really good. If you have the original vinyl of this album, you know it sounds a bit muddy. So this is a vast improvement over that. I wish they would have got a hold of the master tapes, but it still sounds pretty damn good. The 20 minutes bonus material has most of it's previously unreleased. There's a few things that have been released before, but the cool thing about it has previously unreleased radio commercials, which is not, they're not generic in any way. They're specially done radio commercials by the mother, so totally cool, and they sound great. This is the libretto that came with the album. Now originally Frank wanted to put this in the original copies of Absolutely Free, but MGM Verve wanted to censor some of the words. They didn't like them. So Frank said, screw you, we'll put it out ourselves. So that's what they did. So if you have the original album, you'll notice the ad for mailing away to get the libretto. So yeah, I've never seen this before, so it was really cool. It's got an opening letter by Frank on the front page. And then this is all the lyrics. And it's got some graphics. And this is the bonus material. Try and get that. So really cool. Yeah, maybe if they ever do the Freak Out remastering. There was also a mail away thing associated with that album, the Freak Out map. So I've never seen the Freak Out map, so maybe they'll reprint the Freak Out map with that. That would be cool. Alright, you might be asking, what is on that turntable? Well, it's CAC. And I got an original copy of this thing. This album is so cool and so rare. I'm sure a lot of you know it. And I had to pay up on this bad boy, let me tell you. It wasn't cheap. I got a pretty nice vinyl copy of it, so whenever you see the cover on this thing, it's always going to show signs of wear, so this isn't too bad, really. So, yeah, I picked that up locally, and this band was only together like a short time, you know, from 68 to 69, and then they broke up. They released that one album. They were a Bay Area band, featured Gary Yoder, who was originally in the Oxford Circle, and they put out 145 over on the West Coast. So, yeah, Gary, you know, he left the band after they broke up, and he joined later version of Blue Cheer, kind of became more of their front man than Dickey. I don't know what happened to Dickey, but he kind of took a back seat to Gary. I don't know why. Maybe it was drugs. Who knows? But, yeah, really glad to get that. And so we're listening to side two right now, and then later on I'll be playing side one, which is a little more hard rock. And this one's also related to Blue Cheer, and I just picked this one up, and it's Mint Tattoo, and this is an original copy. Came out in 1969 on Dot Records. And this features Burns Kellogg and Bruce Stevens, who first appeared on this album, New Improved Blue Cheer. So, they were on that album, and then they were on Blue Cheer 4. And this is them right here. So, after this album came out, I think the recording sessions started for Blue Cheer 5, which is this one. And I think that's when Bruce Stevens left to form Pilot. And Burns Kellogg stayed into the band, and Gary Yoder from CAC came in and joined. And here he is right here. So these later Blue Cheers are basically sort of like CAC albums more than a Blue Cheer album. And they're spotty. They're not that good, really, in my personal opinion. But there are a few good tracks on each one, and you get to hear more of Yoder's work. So, I think prior to this album coming out is when Mint Tattoo came out. And this was the last Blue Cheer album. And this has got a couple good, real good tracks on it, I think. I really like I'm the Light, which is kind of psychedelic, and it has sitar, and it would go really good on the CAC album. Okay, I guess that does it for this part of the video, and yeah, I'll be doing part two. I'll get it out when I get it out, I guess. And hope you enjoyed the showing. Hope you enjoyed the tunes. And I'll catch you guys in part two later.